Okay, so I'm going to construct a line that's parallel to a given line. So first I'm going to draw a line to start with. I'm just going to call that line L. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a transversal. And the transversal, just to make it easy, I'm going to make it close to a right angle, but not a right angle. It's still going to be acute. So something like that. And you don't need to do that, but it just makes the construction easier. Okay. Your transversal line, it could be going kind of at an angle like this with a ruler here, but that's going to create a problem when you go to draw. It's going to be difficult. Okay, now to complete the construction, I'm going to use the converse of the corresponding angles theorem, which says if two lines are cut by a transversal and the corresponding angles are congruent, then the lines are parallel. So I'm going to copy an angle. I'm going to copy this angle right here and then put a new one up here, and then I'm going to go ahead and draw a parallel line. Okay, so put the compass to a good width. Okay, maybe about like that. And I'm going to make an arc all the way up through so it intersects. Just like this. Okay, let's label this point A. Now from point A, I'm going to draw another arc. It's exactly the same measure like that. Now you could put this point A, it doesn't have to be on this intersection, it could be higher or lower. It really doesn't matter. The important thing is that these arc measures are the same. Call this point B. And let's call this point C over here. Now I'm going to measure this distance from point A to point C and then copy that up to point B. So I'm widening the compass out a little bit. About right there. Then I'm going to translate it from point B, and I'll make a mark right here. And let's label that point D. So this distance from A to C and the distance from B to D is the same. Now I'm going to draw my parallel line. It's going to go through point A and through point D. You want to be very careful here. Make sure you're going through the centers of those points that you drew as best you can. Okay, so right here, here's the corresponding angle, angle BAD, and this angle A, let's call this E, AEC. This angle and this angle, these rotations, remember an angle is a rotation of a ray. So these angles are exactly the same. They are corresponding. Note the positions of these. They're both in the upper right-hand corner of the intersection. Those angles are congruent. So by the converse of the corresponding angles theorem, I can say that line AD is parallel to line L. Or I could also call it line EC if I wanted to. Is that these two lines are parallel, and the reason why is because the corresponding angles are congruent. And you can also do a construction using the alternate interior angles converse. And so I'll just sketch that one real quick. Here's your line. Your transversal would go more this way. And then you would copy this angle here and bring it over here. And then draw your parallel like that. And you can try that one off your own too, but it's really important that you master this one. So I would try this one a few times and make sure you really understand it. And you understand the reasoning why. It's because of the corresponding angles converse.